Next question from Sajjad.
Yes, sir.
Sajjad, you have to tell me that what happened in 1974.
Zubair? Sir, in 1974, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto founded nuclear program, sir. Nuclear atomic program, sir.
No, no. Tariq?
No.
Sorry, no, sir. I have no idea, sir.
Okay. I tell you, Pakistan started atomic program. Pakistan started atomic program in 1974. It was starting year of atomic program in 1974 during the government of Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto. At that time, the government of People's Party was in Pakistan.
Yes, sir.
And Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was the Prime Minister of Pakistan at that time.
Yes.
What happened in 1979, Sajjad?
Yes, sir.
What happened in 1979?
79.
Okay, anyone can reply. Zubair can reply. Tariq can reply. Zain can reply. Usman Ghani can reply.
Sir, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was hanged.
Yeah, good. Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was hanged up in hate murder case.
Yes, sir.
He got punishment. Why he made to Pakistan as atomic power? It was his fault. What happened on 8th October in 2005? What happened on 8th October in 2005? What happened? Tariq? 2005. Zubair? Sajjad, anyone can hear?
In 2005, 8 October, earthquake.
Benazir killed by 2005, Benazir killed, sir.
No. I tell you, then. On 8 October in 2005, earthquake came in Pakistan, and as a result, mostly people were died.
Certainly, sir.
There were major losses took place in Kashmir. What happened in 1992? Tariq?
Sir, we won the World Cup of Cricket.
Okay, who was the captain?
Imran Khan, our Prime Minister.
Oh, yes.
At this moment.
Yes, why not? Imran Khan was captain of the Pakistan cricket team. Now he's captain in Pakistan. He's ruling in Pakistan as a captain. Okay? Captain means Prime Minister. I think you can... Okay, you can practice at home further. Okay, so it was revision about Pakistan. So I have to take start. As Zubair told me that, sir, you have to explain about tenses in English. Okay, Zubair.
Yes, sorry, sir. What you asked, sir?
I have to start revision of tenses in English as you requested in the starting of class.
Yes, sir.
Okay. It will also, tenses can make part of your test.
Yes, sir.
It also, you can say as a language, we can speak it, no problem. If we talk in English, so anything, if we talk or discuss in English, So it's also part of language, no problem. We don't care about his grammar or any topic. Yes, okay, let us start now. First of all, present. What is present event tense? If you do any work in the present time, then if we do any work in the present time, then it is called present indefinite tense. We use first form of verb in this tense. We add s or es as a helping verb with verb. If we use pronouns or subjects, he, she, and it, we use s or es along with verb as a helping verb. We do not add s or es along with verb. If we use pronouns or subjects, they, we, you, and I. Our routine works, habits, and the universal tools are part of present indefinite tense. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Past tense, present continuous tense.
Yeah.
If we do continuous any work in the present time, then it is called present continuous tense. Do you listen to me?
Yes, sir.
Everybody? Okay. If we do continuous any work in the present time, then it is called present continuous tense. We use fourth form of verb in this tense. We use is as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, he, she, and it. We use am as a helping verb with pronoun or subject, I. We use are as a helping verb with pronouns or subject, they, we, and you. Next tense, present perfect tense. If we complete any work in the present time, then it is called present perfect tense. We use third form of verb in this tense. We use has as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, he, she, and it. We use have as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, they, we, you, and I. Next tense, present perfect continuous tense. If we start anywhere from past and we do continuously in the present time from specific period of time, then it is called present perfect continuous tense. We use fourth form of verb in this tense. We use has been as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects. With pronouns or subjects, he, she, and it. We use have been as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, they, we, you, and I. We use far as a specific period and we use since as a specific time. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Next, past indefinite tense. If we do any work in the past time, then it is called past indefinite tense. We use second form of verb in this tense. We do not use helping verb in this tense. We make short sentences in this tense. We use verb in the end of sentence in Urdu. Next, past continuous tense. If we do continuously any work in the past time, then it is called past continuous tense. We use fourth form of verb in this tense. We use was as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, he, she, it, and I. We use were as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, they, we, and you. Past perfect tense. If we complete any work in the past time, then it is called past perfect tense. We use third form of verb in this tense. We use had as a helping verb without pronouns or subjects. We use two tenses in this tense. First of all, we use past perfect tense, then we use past indefinite tense. We use before between two tenses. Past perfect continuous tense. If we do continuously any work in the past time from specific period of time, then it is called past perfect continuous tense. We use fourth form of verb in this tense. We use had been as a helping verb without pronouns or subjects. We use for as a specific period and we use since as a specific time. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, next tense, future indefinite tense. If we think about any work to do in coming time, then it is called future indefinite tense. We use first form of verb in this tense. We use will as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, he, she, it, and they, you. We use shall as a helping verb with pronouns or subjects, I and we. If we have strong will, then we use will with pronouns or subjects, I and we. If we have not strong will, then we use shall with pronouns or subjects, I and we. Okay? Next tense. future continuous tense. If we think about any work to do continuously in coming time, then it is called future continuous tense. We use force form of verb in this tense. We use will be as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, he, she, and they, you. We use shall be as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, I and we. Next tense, future perfect tense. If we think to complete any work in coming time, then it is called future perfect tense. We use third form of verb in this tense. We use will have as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, he, she, and they, you. We use shall have as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, I and we. We use two tenses in this tense. First of all, we use future perfect tense. Then we use present indefinite tense. We use before between two tenses. Last tense, future perfect continuous tense. If we think about any work to do continuously in coming time from specific period of time, then it is called future perfect continuous tense. We use force form of verb in this tense. We use will have been as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, he, she, and they, you. We use shall have been as helping verb with pronouns of subjects, I and we. We use for as a specific period and we use since as a specific time. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, I want to tell you about negative sentences and interrogative sentences.
Okay, sir.
In the negative sentences, we use not as obligatory, as compulsory. We deny in these sentences. And we use not after helping verb. Except, you know, that present indefinite tense, that he goes to office, he does not go to office. Now here we added here does, then we attached not with it. Now I went to office, I did not go to office. In past indefinite tense, we use second form of verb, I mean to say did. We used did as a second form of verb, then we use first form of verb. You have to take care about it, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Further, you know, intense is that I tell you about present perfect continuous tense. He has been going to office for many years. In negative sentence, he has not been going to office for many years. We use not in the mid of helping verb. Has not been, okay? Same here. In past perfect continuous tense, had not been in the negative sentence.
Yes.
But in future perfect tense, if you make negative sentence, then we say will have not. We must have keep a difference. Will have not in the negative sentence.
Yes,
okay. We don't use not in the mid of helping verb. After helping verb, we use not in the future perfect. If we change to future perfect tense in the negative sentence. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Other things you have in your record, everything. In interrogative sentences, we have to use helping verb in the starting of sentence. And we have to use interrogative sentence as obligatory, as compulsory in the end of sentence. In the interrogative sentences, we ask questions. Okay?
Okay, sir.
And now active as passive voice. In active voice and passive voice, we can change to 9 tenses from active voice to passive voice. We can't change 3 tenses from active voice to passive voice. I mean to say present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense, and future perfect continuous tense cannot change from active voice to passive voice, but remaining tenses can change from active voice to passive voice. We use third form of verb in the passive voice. We change all pronouns in the passive voice, and all pronouns come in the end of the sentence. And we use by in the second last of passive voice. We use by. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now I tell you about helping verbs. I tell you about helping verbs of passive voice. In the, if you change to present definite tense, in the passive voice, we use is as a helping verb. If we change to present continuous tense, we use, in the passive voice, we use is being. In the present perfect tense, if we change to present perfect tense, then in the passive voice, we use has been as a helping verb. In the, if we change to past indefinite tense, then in the passive voice, we use was as a helping verb before third form of verb. If we change to past continuous tense in the passive voice, then we use as a helping verb was being. And in the, in, if we change to past perfect tense in the passive voice, then we use had been as a helping verb. In, if we change to future indefinite tense in the passive voice, then we use will be as a helping verb. If we change to future continuous tense in the passive voice, then we use will be being as a helping verb. If we use to future perfect tense in the passive voice, then we use will have been as a helping verb, P-double-E-N. In continuous tenses, we use being, B-I-N-G. But, I talk about present perfect tense, past perfect tense, future perfect tense, we use been, B-double-E-N, been, okay? Tariq, Sajjad.
Yes, sir.
I think during my revision, everybody slept.
No, sir.
But
we present, sir.
But only I think you were listening in your dreams. I think so.
Not now, sir.
Oh my God. Anyways, you know that you are well conscious about your self-introduction tomorrow in your test. I tell you one thing, that I can ask you anything in English about grammar or about topic on Pakistan and self-introduction. Keep in mind this thing. It's also a good sign for you that if you can explain in English, it is very good sign for you. Got it now? Tariq, Zubair, Sajjad, Zain, Usman Ghani.
Yes, sir.
Tariq.
Got it, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Got it, sir.
And I expect from all of you that you have to show good performance tomorrow.
Inshallah, sir.
Inshallah. So if you have to devote 1 to 2 hours for your practice for test tomorrow, everything is possible in the world just by struggle. Struggle is obligation. It is obligatory.
Yes, sir.
And I mentioned many times that if somebody struggles, so concerned person is friend of Allah.
Inshallah.
Friend of God. Okay.
Yes, sir.
No doubt, any sir. Question? Sir. You have any question regarding revision? So you can ask me without any hesitation.
Sir, I have a question, but not to regarding revision, sir.
Okay.
What is difference between it and this, sir?
It and this. It and what is the difference? Where we have to use?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Certainly, sir.
Okay, understood. It we have to use for rain. For motionless things. For motionless things, we have to use it. This we have to use for boy. This is a boy.
Yes, sir.
For indication purpose. And we have to, by finger, we have to say, this is a boy. Okay, in this way. Okay?
Okay, so this is a boy.
Is obligatory. And it we have to use for motionless things.
Okay, sir.
And this is a boy.
Sometimes we use this is not fair, or it is not fair, sir. Which is correct?
Is not fair. Why not? Understood now. It is unfair.
It is unfair.
Why not? We have to use here it. It is unfair. But we have to as a statement we have to use here. Got it now?
Yes, sir.
we can say that in language we have to use it. We use it in language. It is unfair. It is fair. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
It is raining. So you know that in language you have to. I will for general information. But you know yes. that these words, it is not. I'll tell you one thing. We have to, especially for specific sentences, we have to use it. But it is not common use. Okay.
Okay, sir.
It is not. You can say for specific sentences we have to use it, but it is not very common. Did you understand yes, now?
Yes, sir. Sir, few minutes ago, sir, we say a word devote, sir. Which is meaning of devote, sir?
How do you spell?
Devote.
No, how do you spell?
D-E-V-O-T-E, devote.
Devote.
Yes, sir.
Devote means give, offer.
Okay, sir.
You know?
Give. Yes, sir. Give or offer, sir.
Yes, as our forefathers, devoted many sacrifices, offered many sacrifices for Pakistan. Our forefathers devoted their life for Pakistan. Got it now?
Okay, got it, sir. Got it.
Yes. We have to take, take it as a sacrifice, devote.
Devote. Okay, sir.
For property, for lives. Got it now? As a sacrifice.
Okay. Understand, sir.
Yes, okay, good. Yes, Tariq, any questions? Sajjad and Zain, Usman Ghani, Tariq? No question?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Everybody have to come in time for test tomorrow, sharp 7 p.m. Inshallah. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Inshallah, sir.
And everybody should present tomorrow. Got it now? Okay, class is going to end now. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz, sir.